Hey, this is take two. So I decided to record today about potential people like yourself, especially if you're watching this video and thinking you tend to suffer from like a case of like Monday blues. So if you know what I'm talking about and you're dreading going to like work tomorrow or there's something that you've got planned, I've got top tips, but then I just thought instead of getting right into it, tomorrow morning, like when you wake up, some of you may be seeing this like on replay when you wake up tomorrow. So it's about taking control of your day, and it doesn't necessarily just have to be Monday. So when you're checking in, feel free to introduce yourself first of all, because I'm curious. I want to know where you're checking in from, and then tell me what's your bad case of Monday blues. So let's just play a little bit of like music to get your Monday going. Let me know who you are as you're checking in. Stop. Okay, so Mondays should generally, or any day should generally be like this. It's about taking back control of your days. So how can you do this? My top takeaways, I've gone through this experience of feeling as though Mondays are a drag. You have to get up and you're counting the days, and then you're thinking like it's Wednesday. Now in the US it's called something else, and for the people who are from the US, I'm pretty sure you can spell it out if you come across like this video, when you come across this video. Then there's the countdown to like the Friday, and then the Saturday, Sunday, and then it becomes like repetitive, like Groundhog Day. So the tips I have for you tomorrow morning, if you want to embrace this and then start to love Mondays so that they don't make any difference in your lives and you're feeling like more energetic, it's about try first tip, waking up early in the morning, 1 hour earlier. 1 hour earlier, then call it anything that you want to call it, and that will be your special time. Okay, special time where you just focus like on you. And what I do for myself anyway is like when I wake up in the morning, I have about four or five routines. So some of the routines that I'll share with you are like meditation. Meditation is one of the key things that I do. Exercise is another one. So I break them into like 10 minutes or 15 minute sessions each. Then until it fills up like the whole hour. So meditation, exercise, positive affirmations, and I'll read some of them out to you like in a few minutes. Then I'll also like read a book, 4 to 5 pages each. It might not seem enough, but it's about stimulating the brain rather than actually going like on Facebook. Then I also write down like my goals on how like I want to, if I've written them the day before, then I'm also looking at those goals as well, like in the morning. But I have 2 hours, and my next hour is like an attack of the goals. So it's just that special hour where I'm scanning through. So within that hour, I would get so much energy. I'd feel energized because the day before I would have already had goals outlined. And in the morning, I'm thinking about, okay, how am I going to just focus on this so that I produce outcome-focused goals? Yeah, so the reason why most people don't like Mondays is, and if you're in this situation, it's about also where are you in life? But obviously, at the moment, things are not going to change. So it's about, first of all, embracing the positive outlook. When I mean positive outlook, it's more about not necessarily waking up all cheery, but some people do. But it's about controlling your mindset so that you start to take you start to take more appreciation, gratitude, like for the smaller things in life. So I'll give you examples of like positive affirmations. And interestingly enough, I found some for like Mondays. So here we go. The first affirmation, I am in control of my own thinking. Okay. I think of only thoughts that create and fulfill the best in me. So these are the positive affirmations that you can say. My mind is constantly in tune with the positive. I am full of great thoughts and positive ideas. Yeah, so as you start to say this, then your mind starts to embrace them, but also say it in a way that you actually feel connected to this. And if you need to, stand in front of the mirror and say it out loud. Nobody will think you're crazy, but it's just to get the energy going there. And then another one, or quite a few of them, it's my thoughts are bright, cheerful, and enthusiastic. Yes, I consciously choose what I think. So I make the decisions to consciously pick or choose what I think. I always choose thoughts that are positive and beneficial to me. So as you stress it out, I can even feel it now and the impact that it's having with me. Like in the morning, it's starting to awaken like my brain. So all of my thoughts create healthiness within me. All of my thoughts create healthiness within me. I remember to think positively all day, every day. So these positive affirmations are things that you can create yourself, or you can also find them on YouTube, which is like a great resource for a lot of like information. Then the gratitude is more about what are you grateful for that moment, like when you wake up in the morning. You know, the smaller things that you may not recognize, such as being able to wake up, being able to breathe, being able to enjoy like another day. The second tip that I also have that probably may be useful for you is thinking about extending happiness or gratitude or making somebody happy as you leave your house or you know you're abroad and you're commuting, saying hello to people, you know, to make their day, you know, showing other people that you appreciate them. So extending that to like a workplace. So for instance, if you think, oh my goodness, I'm going into work tomorrow, am I going to have like a fantastic day? So spin it around and think more about how can you help a colleague tomorrow and make a difference in somebody else's life? And think about how can you engage like in a different way if you're going to work. Think about what else can you do like in your work environment to make it more exciting? And let me pause my in the background, I've got Skype making a bit of noise. Okay. So as you're checking in again, do feel free to say hello and let me know where you're from. And if you've got like any useful tips about what you do like on Mondays, and also share if you suffer from like a case of like Monday blues, you know, and sharing is loving, sharing is caring. I'd like to know where you're checking in from. So I've shared like three useful tips. Useful tips in the morning are it's dedicating like an hour before you wake up. And then having dedicated four key tasks, which you can watch over again, that you just allocate to that 1 hour. Then the second one, it's about how do you actually connect with people as you're leaving, make their day. You know, so when you externalize and do not think about how bad the day is, you start to receive something more positive. When you see somebody else smile, and somebody else appreciate you recognizing them, then that also takes away like any negative feelings that you may have, or any sadness that you may have woken up with starts to change because somebody else is feeding you something that's quite positive. So it's when you reciprocate that and it builds on and builds on, it can become something that's a little bit more addictive. Like this weekend, I went to a supermarket and somebody actually was patient enough to let me order something extra. And I wished him happy holidays. I also recognized him before that. I smiled and he was very happy and he wished me happy holidays as well. So I tried to make an effort at least to speak to 3 or 4 people, but it's just become natural now. But in the beginning, I was doing that. And you start to feel it. And that's what happiness means, or being positive, is because you're feeding your brain something different, which is opening yourself up to abundance. Then thinking about in your workplace, that's your given situation. How can you take control? How can you make it more fun? How can you make it more exciting, like with colleagues, so that you're not counting down like the hours before you leave and go home, and make a difference in somebody else's life? So if you definitely do try this tomorrow, get back to me and let me know how your day went. Wishing you an awesome, fantastic Monday, and for the rest of the week as well. So I'm checking out for today, and look forward to hearing from you. Ciao for now.